nothing like kissing your beloved and then watching her melt into a pile of goo faster than the cast of an Indiana Jones movie.
Didn't he kiss another woman in another horror movie who was melting, or she then melted?
Oh, yes. In The Shining, he kissed that older woman who was melting away into a pile of goo.
Gross.
Oh, you're far too sensitive, Captain.
Sensitive? I can stand anything you say about me, Jack.
No, you can't. You're far too sensitive.
Untrue. Go ahead. Say something about... Say something you think I can't stand to hear. Sensitive. Anything at all. Talk about me mum. Talk about me weight. Go ahead. There's nothing you can say that will bother me.
Nothing?
Nothing.
1-877 cars for kids. K-A-R-S cars for kids.
No, stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
I stand corrected.
Well, Captain, that was scarier than the ghost stories about the Whiskey Rebellion.
What? The movie?
Oh, no. The 1-877 cars for kids jingle. You know, K-A-R-S.
Stop it! Stop it!
In any case, the Whiskey Rebellion was really cool, Captain.
Plus, we know where to go to if we want to take a step back in our own time. Right, Captain?
Hate that song.
What's the movie for next time, sir?
I'm pretty sure it's Man in the Attic. You know, the Jack the Ripper feature.
Oh, yeah, okay.
What?
Captain, with all due respect, you've been promising that movie for over a year.
Well, this time it's for real.
Yeah, sure it is.
No, this time it's for real. Jack the Ripper.
Yeah, as in getting ripped off.
No, this time it's for real. In fact, we have a new sponsor for next time. Steel City Con returns.
Really?
Aye. But first things first, here's a little sample of our next show. Roll it!
Out of this if he's human.
I'm afraid he isn't human, sir. Not until what he did to that girl.
Young women, alluring women, hunted down by that relentless fiend whose scarlet page in the history of crime is signed Jack the Ripper.
Don't come up here.
He shocked you as the gunslinger in Shane. He won an Academy nomination for his gripping performance in Sudden Fear. Now, Jack Palance gives you his most electrifying performance as the Man in the Attic.
Your police methods will never trap the one you call Jack the Ripper.
Drawn back from his mysterious errands in the night by the fascination of the girl downstairs.
You are evil.
Well, don't beat around the bush, Captain. What are you really trying to say?
I'm saying that looks like a turd.
A turd? It's Jack the Ripper!
Yes, but he falls in love? What the hell is that all about?
Captain, don't disappoint the sponsor.
Yes. I mean, it looks thrilling with all the love. and stuff and girls dancing in a Jack the Ripper movie.
Well, Captain, there are girls dancing.
Oh. Oh, yes, yes. I forgot about that one. Let's see that trailer again, why don't we?
Sorry, Captain. No time.
No time? The show's over.
Yes, but the Whiskey Rebellion is just beginning.
Yes, yes, I will be there. It looks like a lot of fun.
Mr. Bones, if you are there walking around, people will certainly be screaming.
Oh, yes, right. Stupid curse.
Unless it's Halloween. Or one of the haunted walking tours. And this year, I know someone that just might be involved with that one, but we'll see.
A tour guide?
Someone that knows what they're doing?
I'm talking about me, you idiots.
Stop.
I'm serious. But more on that later. Maybe. Perhaps.
Stop! You know, sir, they didn't have GPS back then.
What? I can read a map.
Really?
Sure. I have one to me ex-wife's house.
For what?
Booty calls.
You know, I can read a map backwards, too. But that's just spam. I'm funny.
But seriously, I can read a map. Where would I be not being able to read a map on the only show where it's Halloween all year long?
All right. Didn't you have a map to the lamp?
What lamp?
You know the one. Aladdin's lamp. You buried it when you found it in the sand on the island. And you said, next to the island, it was the most important possession because of its power.
I said that?
You did. Then you said the power was too important to just leave on the island. Then you brought it to the ship. But then you said it was too important to keep here if we ever sank. So you buried it back on the island. So, if you can read a map, where is it exactly?
Curious. How is it they still cannot see us, sir?
A 22nd century invention called a cloaking device. And why do we not attack, sir, once again? Because the captain, while an idiot, commands a ship that is well-armed grown. Patience. This is all a part of my plan. Victor, are you there?
Yes.
Jeremiah, are you there?
Yes.
Are your ships prepared?
Yes.
Drake measures time by episodes of those moronic movies he is forced to host by the curse. What is your ETA to our location?
Our refit took longer than expected. By Drake's time measurement standards, we are looking at the next movie he hosts. Possibly the one after that.
No faster.
Not if you want us to arrive at 100% capacity.
Victor, our engines are having trouble conforming to the power proficiency of the refit. I would say about the same time, perhaps slightly longer. This is truly maddening, but necessary, I assume. Very well, we will bide our time.
Why is it important that we are on Drake's schedule.
Yes. Why can you not attack now? You have a cloaking device. You have the advantage.
Because Drake is highly armed, and there is strength in numbers. And I want an audience for his downfall. Because of the curse, he has a connection with a network that allows his broadcasts to be seen not only inland, but around the world. I want the world to see Drake's defeat, that it's decisive, and he should not captain the haunt. I've been to the island once. I know it exists. I know the island's power, and know not to underestimate it. We will wait for the both of you to arrive, then I will take the location of the island from Drake, transfer my flag there, and use the haunt as my personal dreadnought, while Drake witnesses the entire affair from its brig. And you both shall be rewarded with riches you cannot even begin to fathom.
If you have been to the island once already, why do you even need the haunt or Drake?
Because it's like the island is alive. It moves. I tried to venture there after my initial visit, but it was gone. Gone from all charts and preliminary findings. For some reason, only that idiot Drake knows how and when to find it.
Isn't it more plausible to believe that your coordinates were simply off?
You do not know this island, Jeremiah. You have not witnessed what it can do. You have never seen its power, what it's capable of. This lamp alone is an example of that power, but without the genie, it's worthless. Returning to the island will reinstate that power, one that is beyond all comprehension. Just like I took Drake's eye, I am always one jump ahead of him.
How can you possibly know his every move?
My agent has piqued your curiosity. One that has done the job admirably, quite to my surprise. And it is as simple as luring the fish in with the proper bait. How do you think we found the haunt so easily?
Having a successful double agent in Drake's house, signaling their whereabouts every step of the way, is hardly cause for parades and praise.
Drake is none the wiser. He doesn't even know or suspect. He's far too trusting.
But you have actually seen the island for some time. You have been following him for weeks. Why not seize the island when he hosts a new show? When it's right there for the taking.
Because the haunt and her crew are constantly between us. Their rigging makes them fast. Their guns make them powerful, and the wind is always at their backs. And then the island disappears into the fog or the mist and moves once again. No, we must wait for your arrival. Then we will strike together and take the island and all her gifts. So batten down your hatches, gentlemen, and fair winds to you both. Make haste.
If I may be so bold, sir,
once you defeat Drake,
what of her crew?
When I command the most powerful force in the world, I'll fry Drake's first mate for a celebratory dinner. Make the professor my beloved, execute the crew, and have the good captain's head mounted on my wall of accomplishments as my greatest trophy. Soon, Calico. Soon.
Booty, our after show, seen immediately after Dead and Buried Treasures ends. Captain Calico Drake and series creator Eric Sprouse take your calls for up to an hour, answering questions about the series or whatever's on your mind about the Swashbuckler's Haunt, the club, convention appearances, and much more. That's our after show, The Pirate's Booty, taking your booty calls till the wee hours of the morning, immediately following Dead and Buried Treasures on most affiliates.
Ha 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 ha!